Something passed through the 9th division of the Tuat. The boat of the sun arrives at the 10th division, which is passed through by the sun during the 10th hour of the night. In the middle register are 1. The boat of the sun, in which the god stands under a canopy formed by the serpent Mehen. He holds the symbol of life in his right hand, and a serpent, which serves as a scepter, in his left. 2. A large two-headed serpent called Thes Rau, which is depicted in the form of a pair of horns deeply curved towards the ends where they meet. The head which faces to the right has on it a white crown, and is directly opposite to the face of a goddess, who also wears a white crown, and is called Hurt Ermut, and the head which faces the left has on it a red crown, and is directly opposite to the face of a goddess, who also wears a red crown, and is called Shemerti, i.e., she of the two bows. The serpent is provided with two pairs of legs. One pair is turned to the right, and the other to the left. Within the curve is a large hawk, which bears the name of Hera Kenti. 3. A boat, wherein lies at full length the serpent Ankhta. 4. Four male figures, each of which has a disc in place of a head. Each grasps in his right hand an arrow, with a spear-shaped head, which rests on his shoulder, and is pointed downwards. Their names are 1. Tephthra. 2. Shisera. 3. Tamau. 4. Utu. 5. Four bearded, human-headed figures, each of which has in his right hand a short spear, which rests on his shoulder, and is pointed upwards. Their names are 1. Setu. 2. Urtau. 3. Kisfu. 4. Sekenyu. 6. Four bearded, human-headed figures, each grasping with both hands a bow, which he holds above his knees. Their names are 1. Peti. 2. Shamirthi. 3. Fisu. 4. Ka. Over the upper register runs a line of text, and in the upper register are 1. The god Punki, who holds an ankh in his right hand, and a scepter in his left. 2. A beetle, called Keeper Ankh, apparently pushing along a zone of sand, or perhaps entering the horizon. 2. Serpents, standing on their tails, which cross each other near their tips. Their heads and necks are bent at right angles to their bodies, and in the space between them rests a disc. The serpents are called Menenui. To the right is a youthful goddess wearing a white crown, and to the left is a similar goddess wearing a red crown, each holding the index finger of one hand to her mouth, after the manner of children, and each is depicted in the act of sitting, but lacks a seat or throne. An axe, symbol of God, standing on the handle end, with a disc resting on the side edge of the head. On the left is a goddess who is steadying the axe with her left hand, and on the right is a goddess who is steadying the disc with her right hand. The names of the goddesses are Netheth and Kenet, respectively. Each goddess is depicted in the act of sitting, but lacks a seat or throne. 5. Eight goddesses, who stand upright, and hold an ankh in their right hands, and a scepter in their left. They face the ape god, whose tail is stiffened out under him in such a manner as to form a seat for him, and who holds the uchit, or eye of the sun, on his two hands. The first four of the goddesses have each the head of a lioness and are called 1. Sekhet. 2. Menkert. 3. Huntheth. 4. Usrit. The remaining four have the heads of women and have the names of 1. Amt Netaroes. 2. Arid Tathath. 3. A hat. 4. The Math Ermin. The name of the ape god is Alf Ermin Matef. 6. Eight gods, each of the first seven of whom holds an ankh in his right hand and scepter in his left. Their names are 1. Armenui, who has the double object in the place of a head. 2. Nebuket, jackal-headed. 3. Amenku, hawk-headed. 4. Hersheta Taui, man-headed. 5. Semhero, man-headed. 6. Amenhero, man-headed. 7. Kent Astef, man-headed. 8. 8. Kent Mentef, a god in mummied form, like Osiris, who wears a white crown and grasps a scepter with both hands, which project from his bandages. In the lower register are 1. The god Horus, hawk-headed and wearing a disc, leaning on a staff. 2. Five lakes of water, in each of which is submerged a male form. These figures are called the submerged. 3. three lakes of water, in each of which is a male form swimming, turned over on his breast. These are called the swimmers. Four lakes of water, in each of which is a male form floating on his back. These are called the floaters. The text for the above is full of lacunae, and whole passages, consisting of several lines, are wanting. The version from Lanzone's edition, Le Domicile de Esprits, PL2, will be found useful in obtaining an idea of the contents of the legends which accompanied the lakes of water. 5. A lake of water. 6. Four female figures, each bearing a serpent on her head and shoulders. The head of each reptile is raised above the head of its bearer, and its tail hangs down her back. Their names are 1. Hedamit. 2. Bekhikit. 3. Chetmit. 4. Synthes. 7. A scepter, surmounted by the head of Set. Its name is Set Nehes, i.e., Set who wakens. The 11th division of the Tuat, which is passed through by the sun god during the 11th hour of the night, is introduced by three lines of text, and in the middle register are 1. The boat of the sun, in which stands the god under a canopy formed by the body of the serpent Mehen. On his head are horns and a disc. On the high prow of the boat is a disc, encircled by a uraeus, which is called Pestu. 2. 12 gods, who march before the boat of the god bearing the serpent Mehen on their heads. Their names are 1. Meni. 2. Semsim. 3. Sekenu. 4. Shetu. 5. Amma. 6. Amo. 7. Erda. 8. Shepu. 9. Netaru. 10. Athpi. 11. Ermanu. 12. Fa. 3. The serpent Semshet. On his back rests the red crown, and in an angle of it is a human head. 4. The serpent Semnebthit. On his back rests the white crown, from each side of which projects a bearded human head. 5. Neith of the phallus, wearing the red crown. 6. Neith of the red crown, wearing the red crown. 7. Neith of the white crown, wearing the white crown. 8. Neith the young, wearing the white crown. Above the upper register is a line of text, and in the upper register are 1. The god Aper Ra Neb Cheta, above whose body, at the neck, is a disc from which proceed two human heads, the one wearing the white crown and the other the red crown. In his right hand he holds the scepter, and in the left the emblem of life. 2. A huge serpent, with two pairs of human feet and legs and a pair of large wings. By its side stands a god with a disc upon his head, and on each side of his head is an uchet. His hands are stretched out at right angles to his body, and each hand touches the end of one of the serpent's wings. An untranslated word may form the name of the winged serpent. 3. A serpent, with a mummied god seated on his back. Above the god is written Chetes, i.e., its body, and by the tail of the serpent is Shetu. 4. The god Tepui, i.e., the two-headed, one head faces to the right and the other to the left. 5. The god Khnemrinit, ram-headed, holding a scepter in his right hand and ankh in his left. 6. The god Nerda, with both hands raised in adoration. 7. The god Ahoefm Khanef, who has two snakes' heads in the place of a human head, his hands and arms are concealed. 8. The god Aptawi, his hands and arms are concealed. 9. The god Merex Ahoef, in form similar to the preceding. 10. The god Oen Ahoef, in similar form. 11. The god Reset Afu, in similar form. 12. The god Tuaharo, in similar form. 13. The god Ma. 14. The god Masekti. 15. The god Hepa. 16. A goddess, seated on the backs of two serpents, which lie side by side, and appear to issue from her feet. Her left hand grasps the body of one serpent, and her right is held up before her face. Her name is Net Ankiu. In front of her are three other goddesses, who are similarly seated. Their names are Net Ku, Nerd Abwi, and Merent Netaru. In the lower register are 1. Horus, hawk-headed and wearing a disc, leaning with his right shoulder upon a long staff, and holding in his left hand a boomerang, one end of which is in the form of a serpent's head. 2. A huge serpent, called the everlasting Set, standing upon his tail. 3. A large pit, with a vaulted roof, filled with fire, wherein the enemies of Ra are being consumed. The name of the pit is Hatet Kedetz, and is presided over by a goddess with the head of a lioness, who holds in her hands a large knife, and pours fire into it from her mouth. 4. A smaller pit, with a vaulted roof, filled with fire, wherein the enemies are being consumed. The name of the pit is Hatet Hantues, and it is presided over by a goddess with a human head, who holds in her hands a large knife, and pours fire into it from her mouth. 5. A pit similar to the above, wherein the souls are being consumed. The name of the pit is Hat Nekenet, and it is presided over by a goddess as in number 4. 6. A similar pit, wherein the shades or shadows are being consumed. The name of the pit is Hat Nemetset, and it is presided over by a goddess as in number 4. 7. A similar pit, wherein the heads are being consumed. The name of the pit is Hat Sefues, and it is presided over by a goddess as in number 4. 8. A very large pit, with a vaulted roof, filled with fire, in which are immersed, head downwards, for male figures. The name of this pit is Ansekitu, the valley of those who are turned upside down. 9. For goddesses, each one with the sign for Eastern Desert on her head, their names are 1. Pesai. 2. Rekit. 3. Hershawes. 4. Sait. 10. The god Herutuf, holding a scepter in his left hand, and the sign of life, an ankh, in his right. The 12th division of the Tuat, which is passed through by the sun god during the 12th hour of the night, is introduced by 3 lines of text, and above the whole scene is a line of hieroglyphics. In the middle register are 1. The boat of the sun, in which stands the god under a canopy formed by the body of the serpent Mehen, on his head are horns and a disc. In the fore part of the boat is the beetle of Kepra, i.e., Kepra, which takes the place of the solar disc that rested on the prow of the boat in the 11th hour. 2. 12 gods, who are occupied in towing along the boat of the sun, each with his head turned behind him and looking at the boat. Their names are 1. Heru. 2. Shemsu. 3. Fina. 4. Bek. 5. Oankiuf. 6. Sebahuef. 7. Aharer. 8. Amqui. 9. Nebamak. 10. Seki. 11. Heknikmu. 12. O. 3. The monster serpent Kaim Ankneteru. 4. 12 goddesses, who are occupied in towing the boat of the sun through the body of the serpent Kaim Ankneteru. Each has her head turned behind her, and is looking at the boat. Their names are 1. Stat. 2. Karawachit. 3. Kaith. 4. Spert Neteres. 5. Netamt. 6. Nebcheta. 7. Hedit. 8. Ankhet Erman. 9. Kertut Tep. 10. Hetep M. Kutes. 11. Bet Neteres. 12. Tesserapt. In the upper register are 1. 12 goddesses, each of whom stands upright, and bears on her shoulders a serpent which belches forth fire from its mouth. Their names are 1. Nefert Kau. 2. Kaithut In Ra. 3. Netsesheish Ta. 4. Nerfert Her Tept. 5. Suachet 8 Bui Pet. 6. Hat M. Taues. 7. Kat M. Sipues. 8. Sekit M. Kues. 9. Hot M. Sipues. 10. Kathankef. 11. Pert M. Ap. 12. Netar M. Wa Apt. 2. 12 gods, each of whom stands upright, and has both hands raised in adoration before him. Their names are 1. Neb Ankh. 2. Hai. 3. Neba. 4. Neb Tuat. 5. Nechimub. 6. Ham. 7. Waab. 8. Hanu. 9. Senset. 10. Matepu Neteru. 11. Festepu Neteru. 12. Hikinu. In the lower register are 1. The god Nu, holding the scepter and ankh in his left and right hand respectively. 2. The goddess Nut, holding the scepter and ankh. 3. The god Hehu, holding the scepter and ankh. 4. The goddess Hehut, holding the scepter and ankh. 5. The god Tibai, man-headed, and holding an oar, or paddle. 6. The god Kashefshef, man-headed, and holding a paddle. 7. The god Nawi, crocodile-headed, and holding a paddle. 8. The god Nai, with the heads of two birds, and holding a paddle. 9. The deity Nesmakef, in the form of a serpent, which pours forth fire from its mouth. 10. The god Nibaku, man-headed, and holding a paddle. 11. The god Kenti Thathef, man-headed, and holding a paddle. 12. The god Ahab, man-headed, and holding a paddle. 13. The god Tuati, man-headed, and holding a paddle. 14-23. 10 gods, each with his hands raised in adoration, their names are Tezku, Themari, Akibu, Sekenu, Ermanu, Kenu-Erman, Bunny, Kuri, Athep, Imneter. 24. The end of the Tuat, which is represented by a semicircular wall or border formed of earth and stones, or perhaps granite. At the middle point of this border is the disk of the sun which is about to rise on this world, and joined to it is the head of the image of Shu, with his arms stretched out along the rounded border of the Tuat. Above his head is the beetle, symbol of Keeper, who has emerged from the boat of the sun god, and below is the image of Af, that is to say, the body of the night sun god, which has been cast away.